A man was on his way from Jerusalem to Jericho when he fell in among robbers, who beat him, stripped him, and left, leaving him half dead. It so happened that a priest came upon him, but when he saw him, he went past on the other side. So too, a judge came to the place and saw him and went past on the other side. But the Samaritan who was making a journey came upon him. When he saw him, he was moved to pity. He went up and bandaged his wounds, giving him oil and wine. Then he put him onto his own beast and brought him to an inn to look after him there. The next day he produced 2 pieces of silver and gave them to the innkeeper and said, "If you spend any more, I'll repay you on my way back."
Now, you've heard it said, love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for your persecutors.
Well, you don't mean hurt you.
I do, only so that you can be called children of my heavenly Father. For if you greet only those who greet you, what reward do you expect in the kingdom of heaven? And if you love only those who love you, what is so extraordinary about that? No, your goodness must have no bounds, just as my Father's goodness has no limit. But be careful not to make a show of your own religion. There's no reward for that in the kingdom of my Father. When you do an act of charity, you don't need a flourish of trumpets like the heathen do in the synagogue or the streets. When you do an act of charity, don't even let your right hand know what your left hand is doing. For that good deed must be done in secret.
What the good master is telling us is that when God sees us doing really good things in public, he writes it down in his big book. And then he...
No. My Father sees what is done in secret.
He will what?
Reward you!
Scripts on the promised land, but you can reach it if you keep on learning.